Boxcar Hippie is back in Rochester at a new location. It's now right across from the Apache Mall. It's not far there from Hot Chip. It's actually right next door. Our Megan Zempel joins us live from Boxcar Hippie this afternoon. She's checking out the new spot. She has some food. She's along with Chuck Sibley, our photographer. Megan, how's it going?
Hi, Cammy. Well, happy Burrito Monday. Is that a thing? If it's not a thing, I'm making it a thing. We're at Boxcar Hippie in Southwest Rochester. And as you can see, I have a giant burrito right here. I ordered this. This is the citrus burrito. I held it up to my head. It like covers my whole face, basically. And then we also have a burrito bowl. Burrito bowl here also looks amazing. I'm here with Roxy Zube. She is the front end manager here at Boxcar Hippie. So Roxy, thanks for talking to us today. You guys closed a couple years ago. You were in Porch Chicken as a ghost kitchen. You recently reopened. Can you explain to us how it's been going?
Yeah.
And when did you open?
So we reopened January 2nd, so right after New Year's. Everything's been going really well, I think. We've been really busy. It comes in spurts, obviously. So, but yeah, I think it's been going really well.
So there are a lot of things on the menu, and they are this building is an old Fantastic Sam's, and Hot Chip is right next door. They took down the wall. Hot Chip is actually connected to Boxcar Hippie, so you can come get a burrito, and then if you're in the mood for a burger, you can head on over and get a burger too. What are some of the things on your menu that people tend to gravitate to?
I'd say definitely the citrus chicken and the steak are our most popular, like, regular meat options. We also have a lot of vegan options, which are really popular. I'd say the chicken for the vegan chicken is also really popular. And then we have vegan steak tips that I think are absolutely delightful, and I'm not even vegan.
Oh,
and so we also have, like, vegan cheese, and we just added vegan sour cream. So a lot of options for vegan or vegetarian people.
That's interesting, because I have heard from people that there haven't been a lot of vegan options out in this area, so it sounds like you're definitely bringing some things to that market. And now, Cammy, okay, I need to say this. We have a little baby burrito with us. Tell us about your little baby burrito.
So this is Carter. She was born beginning of December, so she just comes to work with me most every day and just kind of hangs out with Mom. Everyone loves her. So we call her our little baby burrito.
Aw, she is such a good baby. She's just hanging out while Mom does work.
Yeah.
Aw, thank you. Thank you so much. Well, you guys, check out Boxcar Hippie for some burritos. Like I said, I can't wait to go into this, Cammy. I got the citrus chicken, and of course, I'm all about toppings. So I got a lot of toppings in here. Pickled jalapenos. What else did I get? That Maui Wowie sauce. There's rice in here. Yeah, Maui Wowie. It sounds good. I mean, they have a lot of options that you can customize your burrito. And I'm sorry, this one's for me. Maybe if you're good to me, I'll bring one back for you.
Okay.
I don't know.
But. Hey, Megan, why is it called Boxcar Hippie? Why the name?
Oh, sure. Okay, so it's a question I asked you earlier. Why is it called Boxcar Hippie?
I feel like the owner, Justin, is kind of an old soul, so he kind of likes old hippie-ish type of things. He's kind of a hippie himself.
And the aesthetic here is very hippie vibey. We've got a lot of stickers around, a lot of, you know, chill music. Chill, that's what the kids say, right? Chill.
I think
my
so.
Kids always
Actually,
say chill.
They probably and then, it's probably not anymore.
Probably. It's
Ask
probably
your daughters.
Really 2022. I will, yeah. I use the word aesthetic too. My kids use that word too. And then we also asked, we want to ask you, I mean, are there still hippies around?
I believe so. Very rare, but there is. Yes.
I know, maybe I know a few hippies in my life. I don't know, Chuck Sibley might be a little bit of a hippie. You never know, right, Chuck? He says no.
All right, Megan, thank you so much.
Anyway.
Roxy, Carter, we appreciate it. And Megan, I'm glad you addressed the elephant, I mean the baby in the room. I was like, is she going to go through this whole interview without introducing us to the baby?
The baby burrito.
Yes, the baby burrito.
Thanks,
Megan,
Cammy.
Thank you so much. Live in Rochester, we appreciate you taking the time to join us today.